Hi, everyone. Welcome to Demo, the show where companies come in and show us their latest products and they show us how they work. I'm joined today by John Dietto. He is an enterprise account executive with Omilia. John, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me, Keith. Really excited to be here.
So what is Omilia, and can you explain kind of what it is and then what kind of platform we're going to be looking at today?
Sure. So in a year where AI is everywhere, everyone's talking about it, it's kind of like the dot-com bubble, Omilia is a conversational AI company that has veteran status.
Uh-huh.
We're tenured 20 years in the business, 20 years in AI. So big comparative difference when you're looking at other vendors in the market, and we've been solely monastically focused on omnichannel conversational AI.
Okay, so what do you mean by conversational AI then? Can you explain that?
Sure. Conversational AI meaning anytime a human is having an interaction or a conversation with a machine, right, in asynchronous capacity, right, in real time, back and forth, conversational.
Mm-hmm.
And we are able to do that across all different channels.
All right. And who is this designed for within an enterprise space or an IT space? Like, this platform is designed to be worked within an existing platform, or is it a standalone platform that can then be worked into other software?
So everything about our technology is proprietary. So everything you're about to see today, the demos I'm going to show you and whatnot, everything is built in-house. So it's mm-hmm. a proprietary tech stack. We built our solution from its inception to be as agnostic as possible. So when you're thinking about what horse you have to hitch this to,
yeah.
We play with a lot of different players in the market.
Okay. And so let's get right into the demo, because
sure.
again, the scenario that you've come up with is fantastic, and I love how this works. So explain what you're going to be showing me. And again, this is not just only for fast food restaurants. This is the example we're going to use, but this can be used in any kind of customer service application, correct?
Correct, yeah. And from our inception, we were predominantly within the call center space, but you know, AI has changed a lot. Technology has advanced a lot, and as such, we're finding our solution being used outside of that specific space.
Yeah, and what I like about fast food is everyone has gone to a fast food and understands how bad the connection, the communication can be.
Absolutely.
So let's just jump in and just show me the demo.
Sure, absolutely. Yeah. I'm glad I ate. I hope you ate too, because this usually gets people hungry.
Hi there. What would you like to order?
Hey, yeah, are you guys still serving breakfast or no?
No, but you can check out our all-day breakfast items on the menu. Let me know when you are ready to order.
Oh, darn. Okay. Then can I get a 4-piece nuggets with a Diet Coke light on the ice, please?
Would you like any sauce for your nuggets?
Yeah, barbecue. But can we make that a 10-piece?
All right. Anything else?
Yeah, can I also get a cheeseburger, extra onions, side of fries, no pickles, please?
Okay, that'll be all.
Instead of American, can I get cheddar on that?
Okay.
And I'm trying to lose some weight, so can I get a salad?
Any dressing?
Italian, of course.
Okay, that'll be all?
No, another hamburger for my friend Keith here.
No onions.
All right.
And that'll be all. Thank you.
Okay, if everything looks correct on your screen, the total will be $11.50. Please pull forward to the pay window.
So what I like about this is that it makes adjustments on the fly.
Correct.
As well, if you were looking over on that mm-hmm. on the right side of the screen, you could see that it was making adjustments. But then it also understood just kind of casual conversation, right?
Correct.
Yeah.
Yeah. And really, what we try to do and what we aim to do is not punish inherently human behavior, right? Human beings don't think linearly. People think out of turn, out of thought. We disambiguate.
Yeah.
We infer from context, and that's exactly what we're seeing here, right? Like, even for example, with the cheeseburger. So cheeseburger, extra onions, side of fries, no pickles, please, right? That side of fries has nothing to do with the order of the hamburger itself, but
right.
the system is able to infer that that's a separate line item.
Yeah. And so is this going to be deployed, or has it already been deployed?
It has been deployed. Certain,
uh-huh.
It is testable in several places
yeah.
I cannot mention, or
okay.
I'm going to get slapped on the wrist.
Okay. but we'll figure it out.
Yeah, you'll figure it out. I'm sure you're savvy enough.
But then this can be applied to other examples, right? You have an example where, well, you don't have an example here, but you were saying that this could be deployed in a live chatbot setting or with a live customer service agent, right?
Yeah. So again, everything about communication is about accuracy, right? If you can't understand what someone is saying, you're gonna have a hard time, you know, servicing that person.
Yeah.
When it comes to automated call fulfillment, right? What allows us to break past what is a typical glass ceiling of fulfillment, right? So getting your need addressed in an automated capacity, we're able to break past that because of this inherent proprietary tech stack and a level of accuracy, right? Like even in this demo, you're seeing a pretty much a live configure price quote. And to be honest with you, the latency was a little high today because we're on a public
sure.
network and whatnot, but we can see that these are changing to your point on the fly. And you know, colloquialisms like Diet Coke, light on the ice, and this level of service and functionality and complexity and being able to understand a human being is something that we can replicate across all channels.
Yeah.
And we often do.
And you're working on adding generative AI functionality to just this existing conversational AI, correct?
Correct. So we are very much of the opinion that there is a high saturation of vendors in the market that are overly reliant on generative AI.
Yeah.
There's a lot of unsupervised learning and hallucinations that are happening. And you could take your pick of companies that have deployed a too loosely let go generative AI. And what we've done is, again, I've mentioned 20 years in the industry, we've
yeah.
sanitized a lot of existing fielded customer intents and utterances, and we've complemented those with generative AI. So expanding the language model so it's hyper-focused in a generative capacity.
Okay, and what's the pricing on this platform? Is it a standalone platform, or is it an add-on to an existing structure or infrastructure that you already have? Is it a subscription model? Is it a one-time price?
It's
hosting. I've got like seven questions there for you.
I mean, look, there's a couple of questions. What I could say is this, without signing an NDA, Keith, we are subscription-based, right? So it's largely usage-based. However, that being said, in terms of where we can connect, again, it's very, very flexible. Like here we are deployed in a drive-through environment where there is no uniformity of the hardware conditions on that end. But again, typically our inception was within the call center, and that's largely, you know, where a lot of our bread and butter is: financial services, healthcare, and insurance, things of that nature.
All right, for people that want more information, where should they go? Give me the website.
Sure, it's omilia.com or ocp.ai for those who are a little more technical.
All right, John, thanks for being on the show, and thanks for the demo.
Keith, thanks so much.